counties from Parkersburg, West Virginia, up to Indian God Rock, which is near Franklin, PA. There are three different groups. There's a group here in the Upper Allegheny Valley, there's a group on the Monongahela River, and there's also a group on the Lower Allegheny and also the Ohio River proper. It's the first site that was ever recorded in Corrine County, Pennsylvania. This is one of the few places in Western Pennsylvania, or Pennsylvania period, that you can actually go and stand and say, here it is exactly as it was when the Native Americans were here. The rocks that are exposed today haven't moved for 1,000 years or more. They probably held some religious or educational or tribal significance, the people that created them. There's 60 outs here, and I think we have 179 prehistoric figures recorded at this site. Panel number one is underneath the first set of ripples you see to the north of us, and it consists of a human head with four or five lines radiating from the top of the head that appear to be commonly called power lines, but may represent some type of a headdress. The otter that Parker is the biggest figure in the site. It's about 13 feet long from head to tail. It's back in an outline form. And what's unique about this figure, or not totally unique, but what's different.
You see with the spiritual lines in all the drawings or a lot of the petroglyphs have spiritual lines in them. And the animals all had a spirit. They thought highly of these animals and everything. And actually, you know, it's not like they worshiped them, but they thought of them. They had some good feelings about them, and they all were significant in something that they did.
The Algonquin speaking Indians through this area, Ohio, and up into the Midwest, have a legend of a creature called Mishipishiwa, and it's an antler, generally being what we think of as one of the denizens of the deep. We think that the majority of them were made after 1,000 years. It's very interesting to be able to sit here and ponder what's been put there 1,000 years ago by somebody and in your mind try to decipher what that person was trying to tell us. We have no idea. You know, we can look at them, we can make assumptions, but that culture was so radically different from what we see today. And then, you know, what are people going to think about us 1,000 or 2,000 years from now? Or tribal significance to the people that created them. There's six panels here, and I think we have 179 prehistoric figures recorded at this site. Panel number one is underneath the first set of ripples you see to the north of us, and it consists of a human head with the biggest figure in the site. It's about 13 feet long from head to tail. It's pecked in an outline form, and what's unique about this figure, or not totally unique, but what's different is it does have two incised lines across the body that's called lifelines. Among people
have spiritual lines in them, the animals.